Hi everyone! Adding images to your campaigns and automation emails can help you build your brand and engage your subscribers. They're also essential for making messages easy to understand immediately. Similarly, images lead to excellent retention even when users only see them for a few seconds. I will show you how to add images to your emails as well as some best practices for them. Starting with 7 best practices for adding images to your emails. Number 1, keep the width of your images between 400 and 650 pixels, because this is the best width to use for both mobile and Outlook. Outlook will not scale down images that are 1,000 or more pixels wide. Instead, the image will be displayed at its actual size, causing the width of your template to expand and become distorted. Number 2, break tall images into smaller pieces. Tall images will be compressed by our campaign designer to ensure deliverability. However, your image will lose its quality, can appear blurry, and can take longer to load. If your image is taller than 600 pixels, we recommend breaking your image into separate, shorter images. This will allow email clients to load individual images faster and they will keep their quality. Number 3. Insert the exact image size you wish to use in your email. Inserting a small image and then scaling it to a larger width by dragging the image corner in your email can distort the quality of your image, making it grainy or blurry. On the contrary, if you insert a large image then scale it to a smaller size, the image will appear as its original size when viewed on a mobile device. Number 4. Use image blocks instead of adding an inline image to a text block. Text blocks containing an image and any links in line with that image will not be clickable in some Outlook versions. In addition, text may not wrap correctly around your image when viewed in mobile. Number 5. Avoid text in your images. If images are blocked by a subscriber's inbox, they won't see the text included in your image. In addition, the image may become distorted in mobile as it will need to be scaled either up or down to fit the mobile viewpoint. Number 6. Use alt text. Alt text is a brief description of your image and it will appear in your email if a subscriber has images blocked. I'll show you how to add alt text to your images in a second. And finally, number 7, using an image block to insert your social icons will cause images to scale up when viewed in mobile and may distort your email. Instead, use the social link widget. Now, let's jump onto the platform to see in action how to add those images to our campaign. First, let's upload an image to the Content Manager, which is where we can store our images to use them everywhere in the platform. For example, in any email template, any campaign, automation email, or form. Let's go ahead and click Campaigns, then Content under the Manage section, and once that opens up, we will find our images. We could organize our images by folder in this Add a Folder option, but let's go ahead then and add our image. To do that, we click on Add File and search for the image. Click Open and that's our file added into our Content Manager. Now, let's go ahead and open a campaign up by clicking Campaigns and let's select this first one. On the right-hand side, we can drag and drop the image block into our campaign. From here, we select it and then click on this New Image option. The Content Manager will open up where we can select our image. Keep in mind that image files must be in a GIF, PNG, or JPG file format, and that only one image file can be used per image block. From here, we can drag the bottom right corner of the image to adjust its size. We can also use the options menu on the right to add a link to our image, add alt text to the info field, adjust padding, and much more. You can also edit the image once it's been added to your email. In addition, you can add image files, including GIFs, to text blocks. So let me show you how to do that. Let's select the text block and insert it into our campaign. When we click on it, we will see the option to insert an image into it. So let's go ahead and do that. Now, note that if we use this option to add our images, the image can only appear on the top left or top right of that block. And as well, only one image can be added to each text block. I should mention that we recommend adding images to image blocks instead of text blocks. So I shared some best practices for adding images to your emails today. We also saw how to add images to the Content Manager and then how to insert them into our campaigns using the image and text block. What did you learn from that you maybe didn't know before? Let us know in the comment section below. We're also happy to help, of course, if you have any questions. And now is the time where I invite you to like this video, of course, only if you found it helpful, subscribe to the channel and turn the notifications on. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time.